All right, guys, let's go ahead and put in the brand new fogs. Of course, I'm going to tint these babies up again. This was the best look I ever had. Yellow bulb, yellow tint tube, plus tint lens. The most incredible yellow you've ever seen. Some of you new guys to my channel that haven't watched the last couple hundred videos, you're gonna see what we mean. Woo! Let me start pulling them out. I swear that ramps saved my life, man. I should have got these so long ago. I just don't know why I spent years not using ramps. Because for fogs, especially right now, I used to literally do one side at a time and like sit there and jack it up, put it on jack stands, all kinds of hokey stuff. Now just drive it up, no stands, no pumping, super easy. Four clips on each side, plus a 10 millimeter. In the hand, 10 millimeter, pull, hold, ready for the fogs. And this one doesn't quite stick, so I can't do it all slick. Just don't want to break that clip over there. I don't take out that clip in the corner, but I got plenty of room to get back up here. Let's see. So the fog, you see there? Yeah, you can see pretty decent. All right, take out the clip. Yeah, come on, baby. There we go. Ooh, you see that water dripping off my hand? God damn it, these things just suck. Know what it is? It's up here, washing the car, comes in, drips everywhere down. And see, it isn't in the harness. It's a trick. It's in the rubber sheath, and it's holding up there, and water fills up. You put it down, it dribbles out the hole right there. So it's not as bad as it looks. It's not in the connector. See that? It's just in there. I'm interested to see if these, you know, the Sirius LEDs, remember they weren't aimed exactly both at the bottom and stuff, just because of a little bit less quality control on these puppies. And also very thin. I mean, they work fine. Don't get me wrong. I'm just saying there's always a pecking order, and the JDMs are definitely better. But the JDMs have a little bit more substantial hinge. But as you know, these Sirius LEDs, I mean, they work fine, and I use them for quite a while, but I just love that old fog I used to have. That's why I'm going back to it. I'm not saying there's nothing in the world better. Even I have to admit that probably the Morimoto all-in-one sealed boxes are better, but those are also $170. These fogs, new, these JDMs, I believe, are 59 or 60 or whatever. I could probably get you at least a 5% code if someone really wants it. I don't know if he give me a 10%. He might. I don't know though, because they're not that expensive a bulb. But you know, he might. So if enough people are interested in it, he might give me a little code or something. But so, I mean, I guess I'd probably consider them second. The best thing you can have if you don't want to go to dedicated Morimoto tubes, which are really expensive. I bet that light's really giving you a bad angle on that. Whoa. Bet it's like, it's good for me, but it's bad for you. I'm just getting out these two screws, and then I'll get going. Ooh, that's gonna... Ah! Dang! I got this super sore, tiny little cut. And every time I get any chemical on it, it burns so bad. Should have known alcohol wasn't a good thing. Hey, it'll clean it. So what I'm doing here, I'm just alcoholing off these lenses. Remember, I did polish these up at some point. I mean, they may look bad, but oh my god, you should have seen them before. They were pitted like my headlights before I polished them out and got them clean. These were trashed, so this is actually pretty freaking clean for these things. So I'm just getting off the residue. Now we're gonna do a tint wrap on them. I guess I don't really care about the music copyright stuff as much as I used to. I mean, every time I play music in my video, it's gonna be monetized by someone else and do nothing for me. But you know, this channel is not all about money for me. It's about the love of my life, modding cars, my kids. So it's just so fun listening to music while you mod. Sometimes I just say, screw it. I'm going to just have an enjoyable time for me, not worry about YouTube.
I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the bandango? Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
I'm a poor family.
Easy go, will you let me go? Bismillah. 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 No, 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 no. Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub, devil or something.
For me.
Stretching it. Yeah. Pushing out the bubbles. Don't worry about all my fingerprints. I'm gonna peel off another top layer off this thing. It's a double layer, front and back. It's awesome tint. I mean, this is cheap. This is no-name tint, but it's still awesome. I'm telling you. It's because it's the stuff I've used for a long time. I mean, it's a little bit hard, but I'm just, all you do is stretch it. I'm gonna get out my heat gun. I do gotta do that to get it, you know, real nice. It's kind of a little bit hard. Heat gun will make it a lot easier to finish this up. Hated my voice. I made guitar videos for years, but I always cringed at my own videos. Come on, baby. Jesus, this is tough. And of course, it'll be easier when you peel off. I think it's time to peel off the top layer next because I got most of it secure. I'll be right back. I'm trying not to touch the lens part just to get fingerprints, even though I can wipe them off. I'm just trying not to put fingers on the actual lens part. That's why you got a big square here. That's the exact reason. It's already looking bright and nice. And only touching the edges. I have my grab points. Stretch and pull over the rim. You've seen this before in multiple videos. Stretch and pull over the rim. And you get little crow's feet and you just kind of stretch them extra hard to get out the crow's feet in the middle. I mean, you gotta really take your time on this, or it won't look, you know, real good. It takes a while to get this tint on real nice. And I probably don't want to run the video another 5 minutes. I'll be back. All right, I got it tucked pretty nice. Take the razor around the edge. Actually, right at the black edge. Bad luck with razors. I gotta be careful. Still have that big slit where I just picked up the razor when it was open from down here and put my hand on it. to worry about that blood for a while. Luckily, it didn't need stitches. I have a permanent scar. Where is it? Damn, I can't find it. Sometimes it shows up better than others. I can't see it. From Jeep work on my 93 or 94 Wrangler. I don't remember if there's any videos of that. Man, there might not be. That sucks. My brown camo type Jeep thingy I had. I got tons of posts on it on the Jeep forums. I don't think I have any videos on it. That sucks. That was like a major project. Ooh, I forgot a little bit. All it takes is one mistake to wreck your job. So stop and do it right. Okay. And also expect that there's almost no way to keep the dust out of these edges. It's gonna happen. I mean, the good thing is though that it probably won't get under the lens part. But you will definitely pick up dust around these edges. It's just inevitable. Remember when I took mine off and they'd been on there months when I had, I think, condensation? I don't know if I mentioned it. These did not have condensation yet from all that work we did, remember? But I mean, this isn't like locked in. It's definitely gonna peel a bit, but hopefully the fog itself, you know, the bezel and stuff is gonna hold it a little bit, so hopefully you don't get any under there. I do need to clean it a bit. All right, before I do the other side, let's go ahead and check out what we got. I'm gonna turn them on. Of course, this one only has a yellow bulb, but a clear lens. This has the double yellow hydroponic. A lot of kids outside. It's almost summertime. Ooh, see, I gotta be careful. My door will hit the cement there, but I knew about that. All right. Just turn on the lights, no car needed. All right, before I let you see it, let me cut some lights. All right, let's see. Too bad I can't cut out the headlights. Let me, hold on a sec. Now we got some isolation. It's a little different, but it's not as different as I thought it would be, to be honest. In addition, that's close. I can definitely tell it's brighter, but it isn't that much brighter, which is a point for the Sirius LEDs. They're not bad at all. They're pretty good. But you definitely have more yellow on the new one. This is a more pale, faded, I forget what you call it, a pale yellow. This is a rich yellow. Now, I'm gonna try the bulb next, one with the tinted glass and one without, new bulbs. To see, I don't know if that tint is really doing a lot, and it is creating a lot of imperfection on the surface with just all this glue and everything. Whoa, big bug, you see that? So I want to try one of the new bulbs here without tinting at first. If there's barely any difference, I'll peel off the tint. Maybe it's not really helping as much as I thought it was. Maybe it's just the bulb that's that awesome. That would also help me with cops, not having a yellow lens, which is illegal. And I just have a white one until I turn them on. That would also be an idea. Let me do that next. Let's get the lights back on. And we'll move. I'm seeing spots now. Let me turn the lights off. We'll get back to work. Just real quick to point out the directional stuff I always talk about. So both of these bulbs, their wire aims directly down when they're installed. Let me get this light where it should be. Both of the bulbs are completely facing down when they're tight and turned. So that part's good. However, because you know you unscrew the JDM caps and put these on, the caps aren't gonna ever really line up right. That's just a screw on, you can't help that. But that is regardless of that is the correct word. The wires are right, so these bulbs always clock correctly, unlike a lot of the other cheap bulbs that can be different side to side. All right, guys, I now have both of the new bulbs in both sides. Let's take a look and see if that tint screen, let me get off all the lights, see if the tint screen makes that much of a difference. Huh. I swear to God, I think the one without tint looks brighter. Maybe that's even killing some of the brightness, that tinty little film. It's definitely cleaner. Now, I don't know if it's yellower, but I mean, at this point, we're just counting pinkies. It's too hard to even tell. They're so close, each one. But this one really blinds me because it's so clear. This one blinds me, but you can see the fingerprint. It isn't really fingerprints. You can see the glue and everything on the tint, but this one is just crystal. They're actually not as yellow as I remember them, but maybe that's because I'm not looking at the headlight too. To just see just how different, oh, I'm seeing spots I can't even see. To see just how different they are. I think I'm gonna take off the tint, guys. I'm gonna take off the film off these. I think they're pretty dang nice without the film, and they're cleaner. Even though they're pitted a little bit. Well, you can't really see it. Even though they're pitted a little bit. So that was the untinted. Here, you can kind of see all kinds of just glue marks and fingerprints, little even fingers. Yeah, final decision. I'm going to take off. I'm glad I didn't do them both first. I'm going to take off the tint cover, which is easier for me, easier install for, I mean, next time, I guess. That's it. No tint cover. I thought it made more of a difference than it did from our tests like a couple hundred videos ago. I guess not. That says even more for the JDM fog light bulbs that were in my last video when I unboxed them. However, of course, your one problem is, like I mentioned, the JDM kit doesn't come with tubes. Let me get the real light. Still seeing spots, I swear to God, I can't look at lights that long. The JDM doesn't come with tubes or your choice of color films to really make it nice. And I will let you know when I get an answer on that. I expect the answer to be, sorry, it's just not part of our kit, period. There's nothing they can do about it. But, you know, maybe he'll work something, because I was telling him, a lot of people who buy this bulb want it for the yellow tint that they can put on it, just like this, just like me. So, you know, this, it may be a make or break deal for some people that have to have the tint tube or they're not going to want these. So I'll definitely talk to Jose about that and see what we got going on. Just one thing in this light, I can see that the tinted one is more yellow. However, like I said, the loss in clarity is not worth the extra yellow to me because it's so slight. This one is a little bit less yellow. But that one just looks poor. Even though I was so careful with the tint, it still looks like it has a tint on it. And as I mentioned, the cop issue too, taking the tint off. End of story. I know this video is getting a little long, but some of you guys, for anybody that's still watching, I'll just show you how nice it is, how nice you can tie it up. I just have it through this, let me see. Through that little loop right there, making sure you got a real nice view. And I just put the harness through there. And see, I'm sort of having it like right here at the bottom there. The shadows are kind of bad. Anyway, let me just button that up, snug it tight. Oh yeah, let me see if there's a better place to put that. I don't really like that against that. I'm going to redo it. All right, that's my final decision. A double tie wrap to that little corner piece there. And I don't have any tubes facing up to catch water. And it's not against anything else. I'm just going to leave it like that. Oh, you know what? I got to amend this entire video. These are not Sirius LED fogs. Dang. These are the Zist, remember? I was getting real confused because I sold someone my Sirius LED Fox, and I was just thinking, like, how did I sell them if they were in the car? These are the Zisties that I talked about, which that's saying how good the Zisties are. These were the super cheap ones. I don't know, $10 each, $15 each. The Zists you can find on Amazon. Just search my channel for a word Zist if you really want to see them. I probably have it in the title somewhere or the description. That's why I was so confused this whole time, but I wasn't telling you. These are not Sirius LEDs. These are Zists. So hell, I'd do JDM A-Star is my number one because they're brighter. I'd say the Zists are really number two if you're not going to go with the full enclosure like I talked about earlier.